To be born Welsh is to be born privileged. Not with a silver spoon in your mouth, but with music in your blood and poetry in your soul.
It was formed in the Trinity Chapel by a gentleman by the name of Tom Bundred. Apparently it was formed, and most probably my father was one of them. And I think that they had no money for beer during the week. And they used to go to these small cafes in the main street. Then they decided, they'd be talking amongst themselves. They said, well, let's, they used to sing there, and they said, well, let's form a choir. And that's how Abertillery Orpheus male voice choir was actually formed.
By the time I came to them, the choir was already very well established, because they had been founded in 1908. In 1905, there was a very strong evangelical revival in this area. Now, the result of this was that the churches filled. There was virtually a church or a chapel on every street corner in Abertillery in those days, and the membership flourished, and with that came a rise in the church and chapel choirs. Eventually, it was thought that it would be a good idea if all the men from these various churches were able to come together and to form a choir, because the male choir tradition was already being established, particularly in South Wales.
Remember, I lived just behind the Trinity Chapel, and of a summer's evening, my mother and father and all the neighbours would sit out and listen to the choir singing. Over the windows would be open, and you could hear them. So my first introduction to the choir, I should say, would have been when I was perhaps 5 or 6 years of age.
Mae corau meibion yn rhoi cyfle i bobl sydd ddim yn siarad Gymraeg i dysgu rhywbeth am Gymraeg trwy cyddoriaeth. Roedd y cor yn diddorol parcus i ddynion y tu allan i gwaith, ac yn cynnig dewis arall i dafan.
Singing, dancing, drinking on our pleasures.
There were still miners in the choir. But of course, with the decline of the industry and with its complete disappearance, there are very, very few members in the choir now who have been connected with the mining industry.
I'm the longest serving member of the choir. I joined the choir in 1961, just after the mining disaster in Six Wells Colliery.
The terrible explosion. Everyone started rushing towards Six Bells. And my father worked in the Vivian, which I should say was perhaps about 200 or 300 yards from Six Bells itself. So I joined the rush because I was terribly concerned.
I went down there as soon as I knew, and I did go down after the full rescue team had gone down. I went down afterwards. and help with the rescue.
But after trying to help there, which they wouldn't allow me, because of course they were special men that was trained for these type of things.
And when I came back up, people were still waiting around, waiting for news.
And I got home, and there was my father, sat in his chair reading the Daily Herald and smoking his woodbines, and he'd come out all right.
And people really felt it for weeks afterwards. As much in my own home, because my wife's father was killed in the explosion. And it was felt there, as you can imagine. But it did pass, and going out then with the choir made it all that more easier for me. So I've had some wonderful times with the choir. Some wonderful times.
Under the directorship of Stephen, the choir has expanded, particularly with continental travel. And this was first established in 1982, when we had the opportunity to visit Rome, and we actually met the Pope in St. Peter's Square. We sang for him a little piece called Matka, which translates as Mary, and we sang it in Polish. I can tell you that took us a long time to learn that, because the Polish language seems to be made up entirely of consonants with very few vowels.
In 1984, we had the miners' strike, and I felt very strongly in favour of the miners, although I wasn't on strike because I was a member of the knackers' union.
Well, we were people that weren't miners, thought that it was crazy, and most probably it was. But it was very, very hard time because they were literally getting nothing.
They were hard done by. I think they had a rotten deal. And I think it should never have happened, really.
When they took the mines from Abertillery, well, it's almost as if they took the heart out of the valley.
As far as singing is concerned, it's a wonderful community stroke, a group activity, and many of the men here get a lot of fellowship and friendship and general happiness just from singing. When the week has gone badly, Friday night can still be uplifting, and it's just lovely to see particularly some of the older guys who will struggle just to make a concert or just to make a rehearsal, just to finish their week off.
One more. Joy to the world.
Joy to the world.
We've been singing in Cheltenham for quite a number of years. Firstly, it was for the Girl Guides, and now the latest one was for a hospice,
Catholic
Nazareth House. Yeah,
Catholic hospice.
That's right.
Nowadays, unless you have a skill, there's not a lot of work in around Abertillery anyway. So there's a new railway coming up through the valley, whether that'll make a difference. But on the other hand, sometimes you think, well, does it want to be spoilt again?
I am assured now that the choir is in very safe hands, in the hands of Stephen, who was originally a pupil of mine in school. I feel very happy in that he's continuing teaching in the same tradition which I established.
Praise the Lord, we are a musical nation.